Hello friends, in this video I'm going to show you how you can use 10 short simple steps to embed a short video into a learning environment like Canvas or Blackboard. There's a great many short videos out there on YouTube like the ones I've created that are freely accessible for educators like us to use, and they provide really good content. But one thing I found is that it's not as straightforward to embed them into a web page, so I wanted to show you how I did it. In a previous video, I've also demonstrated examples of how short videos can be used to enhance the student learning journey. You may find this video useful, so I'll put a link to it at the end of this one, so please do watch to the end. Okay, so let's imagine that you found a great short video on YouTube that you want to embed into your virtual learning environment. These are the 10 simple steps you would take to achieve this goal. I'm going to use a page on Canvas to demonstrate these 10 simple steps. If you're using a different system such as Blackboard, then the same principles should apply. The buttons and so on may just be in different positions. So, step 1. Locate a short video that you want to use as part of your teaching. In this example, I'm going to use this one that I've created called 6 Solution-Focused Lessons in Under 60 Seconds. Step 2. Locate the Share button of this short video and then copy the link text. Step 3. On Canvas, create a page for your students to access. Here, I've already created one and written some brief introductory text. Make sure you add a title just above where you want to embed your short video. As you can see, I've used the title from my short video. This is an important step as we'll be using the title as a marker a little later. Step 4. Click the Edit button and paste the code for the short video into the web page. If you tried to publish your page now, this link would not allow you to embed your video. Therefore, if a student clicked on this link, it would take them outside of Canvas and onto YouTube. And you want to avoid this as it's not a good design for their learning experience. To give your students a good learning experience, you want them to remain on this web page. The remaining steps show you how you can achieve this. Step 5. Click the link below this video to access a web page where I've created an embed code. Once on the web page, copy the embed code. Step 6. Go back to Canvas and paste this embed code below the previous code into your web page. Step 7. Copy this final piece of the YouTube share code and then paste it after the forward slash and before the question mark. It's important that you replace this text fully with the last part of the YouTube share code. Step 8. Delete the original YouTube share code and then highlight and cut the embed code. Step 9. We are currently in the rich text editor. To make the code work, we need to move into the HTML editor. You can do this by clicking on this icon in Canvas. There should be an equivalent icon in Blackboard and other virtual learning environments, allowing you to switch from the rich text editor to the HTML editor. Now don't panic. All of this HTML code may look scary at first, but don't worry. Pasting the code is really straightforward. To do this, locate the text containing the title you wrote earlier. Here is mine. And underneath the title, start a new line by placing the cursor and hitting the return key. Then simply paste the code. Make sure all the text has been pasted. If you make a mistake, don't worry, you can undo and try again. Step 10. Click the button to return to the rich text editor, and you'll find that your short video has now been embedded into the web page. Now you can add questions before or after the short video to structure your students' learning journey. Obviously, you can add as many short videos, questions and activities into a single page as you want to guide, develop and enhance your students' learning experiences. Once you're done, click the Save button and then publish the page to your students when you're ready. Hopefully you can see that by using these 10 simple steps, the students don't need to leave the web page to engage in their learning processes. This should result in a better and more seamless learning experience. Do make sure that you save this video and then come back to it every time you need to embed some more short videos. I'd be really interested to hear how you've used short videos in your teaching. Please let me know by using the comments section below. To find out more ways that you can enhance your students' learning journey by using short videos, do take the opportunity to watch my earlier video by clicking the link here. In that video, I offer what I hope are a number of useful suggestions. In the meantime, I hope you found this video useful, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.